Without God, there's no reason for us to be here.
Amen.
And I don't even want to, I'd be remiss if I stepped up and not gave him the praise that he's deserving. Amen. So we're going to count to three and we're just going to let loose in this place. Hallelujah. One. I'm still waiting for Calvin. I'm buying time for him as well. Amen. Two. Three. Give God praise in this place. Others.
Yes.
The person that's sitting next to you right now is getting excited as well because the spirit that is inside of you has to move the spirit that's inside of them.
Yes.
Understand something, that our bodies are made of 80% water. If you're in for any water, you drop a rock in it, a coin, whatever it is, it has a ripple effect.
Come on now.
So when the praise of God comes out of you, your neighbor can't help but to be uncomfortable and usher in the same thing to him.
Come on now.
We use the word hallelujah as the highest praise, right? We say hallelujah is the highest praise. The word hallelujah literally translates into praise Jehovah.
Yes.
So the highest praise you can offer God is to force someone else to offer praise to God. I'm going to count to three. We're going to do this again. Y'all ready? One, two, three. Give God praise. Hallelujah. Listen, there are so many scriptures that encourage the believers and the power that we have together. The word of God says, in my name, there I am in the midst. So God is here right now, and he's being pleased with what we're offering him. No one can come against the kingdom of God. Amen. CJ, hit it. Hallelujah.
Hold me back.
That's the thing.
Hold me back.
That's the thing.
Because when Jesus comes to humility,
Yeah. Amen.
When Jesus comes, undying love. When Jesus comes, faithfulness. And if they look at you and identify you with those things, there we can find God.
Amen.
Yeah, Lord God, listen to me, we're going back to addiction. The same father who's upset about me dying. I have a biological father, I have a stepdad. Shout out to my man Chris, because I had to get that set straight, you know what I'm saying? We were talking about that earlier. But my stepfather had a drug addiction. Everybody say addiction.
Addiction.
He had a drug addiction that was crazy because my stepfather also had 4 kids. So I'm trying to watch how I say this, I know there are children in the room. But out of the 4 children, I was the only one he decided to raise. Not only did he decide to raise me, he raised me by himself. So he named me after him, he dressed me after him, I looked just like him. So much so that they called me Little Him. So his name was Ron, I said, Ron, that's Little Ron. I hate that name, don't call me that, I swear I just got to say it. But they called me after him, and what's so crazy is that he loved me. Like we said, we would lay, he had a queen size bed, he would give it to me, and he would sleep on the floor. Whenever he had to eat, he would make sure I would eat and say, I'm not hungry. Things like that, right? But when you have an addiction, that addiction sometimes cries louder than your love. The love doesn't end, but it cries louder. Lord, I don't care what you're here for. Some people are addicted to social networking. When that blue light go off on your phone, you're like, I got it. And you grab it because what you're seeking is that attention. My man Jason, y'all know Jason is from St. Louis, Christian rapper, stuff like that. I was talking to him and he said, Jay, the problem is that we are instead of wanting to be like God, we want to be God.
Wow.
So we get addicted to the praise of people. I saw a TDJ sermon. I know y'all may not agree with his ministry. I'm not saying I do. Eat the meat, throw away the bones. But moving on from that. As he was ministering, he said, if you want to get your man to be a good man, he was talking to women, he said, give them praise. Tell your man, you know what, you're so strong. Watch how much he works to build up his strength. We get addicted to praise. But my father's addiction was cocaine. So my father got so addicted to cocaine, and it was so funny because he got it laced, and that's how he got all the drugs. Somebody laced his drugs, whatever. So addicted to cocaine that he allowed himself to be separated from his love, which was me. My father told me this, I only love 2 people in my life, your mother and you. That's it. I don't even love my own mother. But when cocaine cried out, his desire to take care of me came second nature. And the thing that's so awesome about it now is because my dad is no longer on drugs. Praise be to God. Praise be to God. That's cool. And I'm not knocking the 12-step program. Not at all. My uncle actually wrote the book for the 12-step program, so I'm not knocking it. But it wasn't the 12-step program that got my father free. It was that his addiction for Jesus cried out more than his addiction for cocaine. Now, when you're addicted to the Lord and the things that are given by God, you start to crave less for that drug habit. And what God does is puts that focus right back to where it needed to be, on his children, on his offspring. I tell you now, my father is a minister now for the last 7 years. He's been delivering people, setting people free, preaching sermons. We have Bible studies on the phone together before any prayer you preach. Listen to this, what God said to him. He said that God told him I was the father that he didn't get growing up.
Wow.
So he, even though being older than me, fed me, nurtured me, helped me to become the man I am now, God now uses me to mentor him so his love with God, his addiction to Jesus, can be even greater.
Right.
Because God has everything we need in that addiction, all right? As long as you're addicted to Christ, there's no negative connotation that comes to that. Let's go, hallelujah.
I'm feeling more better than ever. I'm running the guys together. I'm standing.
impacting me. I want y'all to build because it's greater than what's in here right now.
Come on now.
We're trying to build to impact a city. Then after the city, we want to impact the state. After the state, the nation. And lastly, the world for the sake of the gospel. Amen? So make sure y'all build with us. Here be my man, Trey, and I'll see you back up. God bless.
Yeah, yeah.